In the previous lesson, I discussed how to calculate the gross and net intake rates. The intake rate, as I discussed, is the axis that measures the total number of students or pupils that the state or a particular educational sector is able to admit into primary one. That is the first grade of primary education. Right here, we're going to look at the calculation of transition rate. What is transition? Transition is the movement from the end of a particular level of education to the first grade of the next level of education. For example, movement from the last grade of primary education to the first grade of secondary education. That is transition. Right here, we're trying to find out the rate at which the students are moving from one particular level to the next level. For example, in Nigeria, we want to have the transition from primary 6, which is the last grade of primary education, to junior secondary school 1, JSS 1, which is the first grade of secondary education. How is this calculated? Right here, we have the formula. And the formula indicates that you have number of new pupils in JSS 1 in year T, that is a particular year, over the number of pupils in final grade of primary 6 of primary in year T minus 1, that in the previous year. You are looking at the total number of enrolled students in the at the first grade of the higher next higher level over the total number of students that passed out from the grade before that grade. Right there, we have, let's take some example. Right, we have, so assume there were 459,200 students in JSS 1 or secondary school education in Imo State in year 2010. Out of these, 15,897 were repeating the class. If the number of students in the final year of primary education in 2009 was 793,312, calculate the rate of transition from primary to secondary education for 2009. Now, we need to take note of some certain things here. The figure 459,200, that is an assumption that we assume there were 459,200 students in JSS1. Those were the total number of students that were in JSS1. But out of this number, here we are told that you have 15,897 that were repeating the class, which means the new intake is not up to 459,200, because you have this 15,000. You have the 15,000 that were admitted into that class. And because the 15,000 were part of them, you are going to remove this 15,000 from the 459,200 to get the actual number that was taken into the class for that year. And right here again, we are told here that if the number of students in the final year of primary education in 2009 was 793,312. Again, it means the total number that came out was 793,312, out of which we have what we're going to have left over when you remove this, where you subtract, if you're going to subtract this from this, that is what left in here. So how will it go? We're going to substitute these figures into what we have in here. So if you look at it, you've seen that right here we are having 443,303. This 443,303 is where you remove 15,897 away from 459,200. You will get 443,303. And right here, this is the total number of students that left the last grades of primary school, which is the primary 6. So you now multiply it by 100. You multiply it by 100. That will give you 56%. That gives us 56%. What this indicates is that you have the rate of movement is 56%. And that 53%, what does it imply? It implies that you have the movement. Not everyone, you see that the movement is not really very smooth, because if it's a smooth movement, therefore you will have a higher percentage. But however, there are some things that could affect this movement. For example, in some countries or in some states, you see they have some policies. For example, access to the next level of education may be automatic. They may say, well, you don't need to take an examination. The moment you are done with your last grade of primary education, you move no automatic to the next level of education. Like it happened in Nigeria sometime, although now there is a change. There was a time they were doing automatic promotion. Once you finish from the last grade of primary education, automatically you move to JSS1, which was the beginning grade of the secondary education. Although now that has changed again. Another thing that could affect the transition rate, it may be dependent on students achieving a particular level of performance in certain examination. And this is what is applicable here with this 56%. It is assumed the students were presented for exam, they were tested, and at the end, not all of them could make it. Then it may even be competitive. Sometimes in some countries, it may even be subject to regional ethic or quota system. And because of quota system, some students may be cut off.